I've seen enough.
Yet more awaits you.
I won't look.
You shall. Now see yourself in business, Ebenezer.
Come, come, Mr. Fezziwig. We're good friends, I think, besides good men of business. We're men of vision and progress. Why don't you sell out while the going is good? You'll never get a better offer. This is the age of the machine and the factory and the vested interests.
We small traders are old history, Mr. Fezziwig. Dodos.
Yes, I dare say we are. And the offer is a very large one, I have to admit. But it's not just for money alone that one spends a lifetime building up a business, Mr. Jorkin.
Well, if it isn't, I'd like you to tell me what you do spend a lifetime building up a business for.
It's to preserve a way of life that one knew and loved. No, I can't see my way to selling out to the new vested interests, Mr. Jorkin. I'll have to be loyal to the old ways and die out with them if needs must.
Well, you know what they say about time and tide, Mr. Fezziwig? They wait for no one.
There's more in life than money, sir.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. Fezziwig, sir.
Yes, my boy.
The foreman would appreciate a word with you if you can spare the time, sir.
Yes, of course.
Excuse me a moment.
You can't teach an old dog new tricks, can you, Mr. Scrooge? Nor teach the leopard to change its spots.
Well, I think I know what Mr. Fezziwig means, though, sir.